this edition of Jobless Times, a conversation with the National Employment Law Project.
Welcome to another episode of Jobless Times. Tonight we have a special episode with a special guest. To my left here is Mitchell Hirsch of the NELP, National Employment Law Project, unemployedworkers.org.
Hi, Sam. Hi. Thanks for having me.
Hey, thanks for coming. We really appreciate it. Can you tell me a little bit about NELP for those who might be new to the world of the jobless?
Certainly. The National Employment Law Project, or NELP, as we're usually referred to, is a national advocacy and research organization that specializes in advocating for policy issues that affect particularly low-wage workers and unemployed workers. So we do a lot of work on unemployment insurance issues and have a dedicated website that I was recruited to work on that is specifically for unemployed workers and, strangely enough, is called www.unemployedworkers.org.
So you work specifically with the issues of the unemployed.
Correct. And through unemployedworkers.org, we engage literally tens of thousands of jobless workers and their family members and supporters in efforts to strengthen the social insurance safety net for jobless workers and advocate for jobs programs, income support, and other programs that could benefit not just unemployment insurance recipients, but all unemployed workers, including long-term unemployed workers and those who've exhausted their unemployment insurance benefits, which has become a growing problem and a very large population of people.
Now, this obviously is needed now more than ever. Was this a new effort during the recent crisis, or had it been going on before?
Unemployedworkers.org was started a few years back by NELP, actually even before the current, the most recent recession. But we went through a couple of website upgrades and have really put a lot of effort into doing a significant amount of online outreach to the point where, for example, during the most recent campaign that we led to get the federal unemployment insurance benefits program reauthorized for at least another year, we had a speak out page on our website where people sent more than 380,000 emails through our website to members of Congress, both
I know I sent a couple myself,
Senate.
Yeah.
not only advocating, well, thank you for that, not only advocating for a continuation of the federal benefits program in full, which did not happen, unfortunately. It was reauthorized, but it was cut back significantly. But also advocating in these messages for efforts to create jobs, avert layoffs, and get income support, jobs programs and reemployment services to all long-term unemployed workers, including those who've exhausted their benefits. Unfortunately, that last element was not part of what Congress passed in the most recent extension.
So you mentioned that the recent passage. Now this was the one that was bundled together with the payroll tax cut extension.
That's correct.
And this entire thing that was supposed to be in part stimulus, but in part keeping going the safety net for unemployed workers. So you've done a lot of research about the details on this extension. You mentioned that it's some good and some not so good. Can you go into that a little
yeah.
more?
Yeah. The good part is that there are federal unemployment insurance benefits that continue after a jobless worker exhausts their regular state benefits.
Because they were due to expire, absolutely, you know, for beyond the 26 weeks, right?
Correct. Yeah, the entire federal program would have been discontinued were it not reauthorized in some form. So the good news is that there are federal unemployment insurance benefits that continue beyond the normal 26 weeks in most states. Some states, unfortunately, have already begun to cut back their regular state programs. Michigan, South Carolina, and Missouri have all cut their regular state programs back to 20 weeks. Florida has cut it back to a sliding scale. Georgia is likely on the verge of cutting their regular state benefits programs back from to a sliding scale of anywhere from 12 to 20 weeks maximum. Yeah. But as I say, the good news is that in most states, they still have 26 weeks of regular state benefits, and then this federal extension of emergency unemployment compensation beyond those weeks. The bad news part of it is that the full maximum benefits that were in the prior version of the program were not continued at that level. There were reductions in the maximum duration of benefit weeks over a period of time during the remainder of this year, 2012.
Right.
And unless Congress reauthorizes this program or enacts a new federal extension program, as of the first week of January of 2013, all funding for federal unemployment insurance benefits will end.
So I was surprised to hear this. Now, explain to our viewers how that's different from the way that the previous reauthorizations were due to phase out.
Previously, if the law had not been reauthorized back in 2009, 2010, then if a jobless worker was eligible for a tier of emergency unemployment compensation benefits, then that worker would be able to receive all of the weeks of benefits in that tier that they were eligible for, even after the end of the federal program.
So not everybody would get dumped off right away. Some would have 4 weeks or 3 weeks or
13 weeks or 20 weeks,
right,
depending on whatever tier you might be in. Under the current law is written with a hard cutoff so that no funding nor unemployment benefits, no funding for those benefits will be available after the first week of January of next year.
So basically, this is sort of banking on the fact that the current crisis will be over by January of next year. Is that what they're basically saying?
I don't think that was necessarily the assumption. I think this, in many respects, having a hard cutoff to the program was something that opponents of the federal benefits program insisted on this time around, and that it's a political move to basically say this is it and no more.
So what do you think the politics are behind this? I mean, I know there have been a lot of claims thrown around, particularly on the right wing, but what are the politics there?
Well, I think there is a there's a genuine understanding in both parties that the crisis of unemployment is not going to end anytime soon, but there is also there appears to be a political persuasion on the right that opposes social insurance programs generally. And so I think a significant portion of the conservative wing of one of our two major parties is committed to trying to ensure that at least the federal unemployment insurance benefits program that's been enacted since this recession began is not continued beyond this year. We're going to work very hard to ensure that that is not what happens.
Now, this is always a thing that fascinates me. Do you think that this is, they really genuinely believe, I know it's always lobbed around the idea that unemployed people stay unemployed longer if they have benefits. I'm never clear if they actually believe that. It seems a little like saying only sick people go to hospitals, you know. So if you don't go to the hospital, you won't be sick. Or do you think they really genuinely believe that somehow?
No, I don't think they really believe it. Almost everyone in this country, including members of Congress, knows someone who's been unemployed at some point during this most recent downturn. And most of those people, fortunately, have been able to receive unemployment insurance. Without that, they would have nothing. And that would be extremely harmful. Nobody wants to stay on unemployment insurance. No one really stops looking for a job. You have to be involved in an active work search.
You mean it's not a vacation?
It is not a vacation. I can tell you that from personal experience, having lost a job back in February of 2010 that I had had for nearly 20 years.
What a tough job market it's been. I mean, I don't know if you know how many resumes you ended up sending out during that time, but I know many people have sent out hundreds, if not thousands.
It is. I described it once as the hardest job I ever had was working to try to find another job.
In this environment, particularly. We're going to take a brief break, and we'll be back in a moment with Mitchell Hirsch.